Good morning. Welcome to the seventh meeting of Session 6 of the Delegated Powers and Law Reform Committee. And before we move to the first item on the agenda, I'd like to remind everyone present to switch their mobile phones to silent. The first item of business is to decide whether to take item 6 in private. Is the committee content to take this item in private? Thank you. Moving to agenda item number 2, we're considering instruments subject to the made affirmative procedure. An issue has been raised on SSI 2021-322, the Health Protection, Coronavirus, International Travel and Operator Liability, Scotland Regulations 2021. This instrument revokes three previous sets of regulations and replaces them with consolidated international travel regulations, with the aim of improving their readability and accessibility, as well as making certain specific changes. In correspondence with the Scottish Government, the committee highlighted that Schedule 4 of the instrument provides exemptions from requirements in the international travel regulations for certain people, including members of aircraft crew, as defined in paragraph 10.2a, subsection 2. The term EU ops is used in that paragraph, which is defined in paragraph 10.2c, with reference to the meaning of that term in paragraph 1 of Schedule 1 of the Air Navigation Order 2016. However, there is no reference to EU ops in that order. The Scottish Government has confirmed that this is an error insofar as there is no longer such a reference in the order and undertook to correct this at the next available opportunity. Are members therefore content to report the instrument under reporting ground H on the basis that the instrument's meaning could be clearer in this respect, and to welcome the Scottish Government's commitment to clarify the position by updating this reference at the next available opportunity, which it has now done within SSI 2021-343, the Health Protection, Coronavirus, International Travel and Operator Liability, Scotland Amendment No. 2 Regulations 2021, which is also being considered by the committee today. Yeah. Thank you. Turning now to SSI 2021-343. Are members content with the amending instrument?
Yes. Yeah.
Thank you. The final made affirmative instrument for consideration today is the Health Protection Coronavirus Requirements Scotland Amendment No. 2 Regulations 2021 SSI 2021-349. This instrument brings into force the COVID-19 vaccine certification scheme. Members will recall that the committee asked the Minister for Parliamentary Business a number of questions on the proposed scheme at its recent evidence session and followed this up with a number of points of clarification. The regulations themselves were laid on Thursday the 30th of September before being brought into force on Friday the 1st of October. As such, this is the first opportunity that the committee has had to consider the regulations themselves. No technical points have been raised on the regulations. However, can I invite comments from members on the instrument? Mr. Simpson.
Thank you very much, convener. Start again. Thank you very much, convener. As you've said, this instrument deals with the, shall we call it, the vaccine passport scheme. Everyone knows what that is. And this committee has been asking a number of questions around that for several weeks now of the government. What we have to do today is to decide not whether we agree with the policy or not, that is for the COVID committee and indeed at some point the full parliament. Our role is to decide whether the procedure used is the correct one. And the government has put this through under the made affirmative procedure, and that means that that it has come into effect, it's come into effect without any proper scrutiny by any committee. Committees have looked at it in general terms, but no committee until today has managed to discuss this having the regulations in front of them. It's already in force. Now, the question for me is, was that the right procedure? Now, given that the First Minister announced weeks ago that she and the Scottish Government wanted to bring in a vaccine passport scheme, given that these regulations having to come into force on Friday, the government has said, we're not going to enforce them for 2 weeks. I would argue very strongly that that gives Parliament time to properly scrutinise these regulations. And on that basis, the made affirmative procedure, the procedure that the government has used, which avoids scrutiny, was the wrong one. So that actually what they should have done was put this through under the affirmative procedure. That would have given Parliament a chance to scrutinise the regulations in some detail, unpick them, possibly avoid some of the problems that we all know about that have come up with this. So I would be, I'm not content with the instrument as laid, and I'll be voting against it on that basis.
Okay, thank you, Mr. Simpson. Mr. Hoy.
Thank you, Convener. Just in part to echo what Mr. Simpson has said, I mean, obviously I'm on the record already in this committee and elsewhere saying that I've got policy concerns, practical concerns, concerns about civil liberties, but that's not really what we're being asked to look at today, although I think the Minister's letter to us doesn't give me reassurance that the concerns that we raised prior to the instrument coming forward have been addressed. But that is, as I think has been said, for the lead committee to look at. So what we're looking at is whether or not the use of the made affirmative is the right approach, and we are the arbiter and the gatekeeper in respect of that, and I think it's right that we do that. And it falls down, I think, on whether or not the implementation of this instrument is in response to a serious and imminent threat. And I think, given that the government have been talking about this for 3 weeks and now subsequently delayed it, I very much echo Mr. Simpson's concern that it doesn't meet that requirement, and therefore I don't think this is being put through the made affirmative route because of urgency. I think it's being put through that route because of political expediency, which is to avoid the due scrutiny that I think would show that in many respects this policy is deficient and simply won't work, to be honest with you. So I do have concerns that the government is not going down the right route in that, and I will be following Mr. Simpson in voting against it.
Thank you, Mr. Hoyt. Mr. Sweeney.
Thank you, Chair. I share concerns regarding the level of parliamentary oversight and scrutiny of this procedure, particularly in light of the logistical difficulties that we encountered in the last few days, which demonstrate it was immature in its delivery and that would have benefited from parliamentary oversight, and particularly in light of constituency representations I've received regarding compatibility internationally, as well as the value for money of the actual technical solution decided upon by ministers, merited greater levels of debate in the Parliament, regardless of whether you support the principle of the vaccine passport or not. And I think the policy enacted by the government would have benefited from greater levels of parliamentary oversight. So therefore, I would agree that it merits, I would be better suited to an affirmative procedure than the made affirmative procedure, particularly given also the serious imminent threat, whilst the broad context of the pandemics is valid. The primary purpose of the vaccine passport system, as far as I can see, is to create a negative incentive structure for vaccine uptake, rather than it being about immediate need to, for example, deal with transmission issues, which is more readily dealt with through test and trace or test and protect. So for those reasons, I think it would merit greater parliamentary scrutiny, and I'd support an affirmative procedure in this context.
Thank you, Mr. Sweeney. Mr. Kidd.
Yeah, thank you to everyone, and thanks, Convener. I think that the failure to follow the procedure to make it an affirmative was one which should be made very well aware to the government, actually, and the fact that this committee is unhappy with the procedure as followed. I think it's important that, because of the nature of what we're dealing with in terms of coronavirus, that yes, certainly things have moved on apace, but potentially it's skipped in doing so some of the oversight which is required in the Parliament, and therefore I think that this line should be an affirmative.
Okay, thank you, Mr. Kidd. Also, there's a number of points have been raised. I mean, we clearly as a committee have got an instrument in front of us, and certainly there are no technical points have been raised on the instrument in front of us, but notwithstanding also points that colleagues have raised. My personal thoughts are that obviously we have to vote on the regulations in front of us, and with the fact that no technical points have been raised, then I will vote for this particular set of regulations, notwithstanding. I think it's the points have been raised by colleagues around the table regarding the procedure that was actually used, whether it should have been made affirmative or affirmative. I think it'd be right for this committee to actually write to the Scottish Government asking some other questions around that, but also highlighting also concerns that colleagues have raised, particularly as we may, who knows what's going to happen at some point over the course of the winter period, and whatever actions may or may not have to take place as a result of that. So with that, clearly, I'll ask the question, but I obviously understand what the answer will be. Is the committee content with the instrument? Okay. So with that, there's going to be a division. So can I ask those who are content with the regulations to please raise their hands? Okay. And can I ask those who are not content with the instrument to please raise their hands? Okay, thank you. So, and obviously there are no abstentions. So, with that, so the vote was 2-4 and 3-against. So, therefore, this instrument is not agreed. So, the committee is not content with the regulations. A report will be published setting out the committee's decision in relation to all the instruments it considers today, and will include a summary of the committee's discussion. But also, we will write to the government, as agreed, highlighting the points that have been raised regarding the procedure that was used. Okay. Under agenda item number 3, we are considering instruments subject to the affirmative procedure. No points have been raised on draft instruments, the Winter Heating Assistance for Children and Young People Scotland Amendment Regulations 2021, and the First Tier Tribunal for Scotland Chambers Amendment Regulations 2021. Is the committee content with these instruments? Thank you. Under agenda item number 4, we're considering instruments subject to the negative procedure. No points have been raised on SSIs 2021, 333, 335, 340, and 341. Is the committee content with these instruments? Okay. And under agenda item number 5, we are considering instruments not subject to any parliamentary procedure. No points have been raised on SSIs 2021, 332 and 339. Is the committee content with these instruments? Yeah. Thank you. I will now move the committee into private.